I'm a genius. I mean, the streets have been schooled them and made them slicker than slick with the ruler. I've lost a lot and learned a lot, but I'm still undefeated like Shooter. I'm far from cheap. I break down companies with all my peeps. Maybe we can travel the world and I can. Funny. Difference is I own it like a stopwatch. Let's stop time and enjoy this moment, darling.
I know I could jam out to that song all night long, Annie. Welcome, you guys. It is Friday, September 23rd, and it is Empowering Your Finances 2022 with myself and Annie Guevara. You are our Friday night date. You know, I was thinking about that earlier. I'm like, you know what? I actually put on my story and I said, if nobody has a date tonight, please come join us, you guys. We're going to be talking everything in line with finances. So thanks for being here, Annie. I'll always love to be side by side with you and have this amazing moment together. And the first thing we want to jump into tonight is student loan. It's a hot topic right now. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail tonight because student loans, we all know they are a not one size fits all. Nobody's situation is the same. So, but there are some things that are the same going forward that I think everyone needs to know about, right? So one, kids are knocking on the door. I unlocked it. I don't know why they can't get in. We'll see what happens. So first thing I want to chat with you guys about is student loans. They have been extended one and apparently the most final one is going to be, they are due in January of 2023. That's when we all, whoever has student loans out there, one myself, I know I do. And we have to start repaying them in January of 2023. So the kids are still knocking on the door. They're so funny. Anyway, they're totally distracting me. So student loans, they are going to be due for payment come January 2023. But what I wanted to give you guys is a little bit more insight into what is in detail. You know, we've heard about the loan forgiveness, all these different things. And I kind of want to just run down this program with you guys. But like I said, at the end of this, if you guys have student loans out there, hold on one second, you guys. The door is unlocked, baby. Yes, it is. Okay, I'll be right there.
That's how the life of a mompreneur is.
Yes.
Welcome to our world.
Give me one second. Can you take over while I go apparently let them in?
Of course, no problem. You see? That's what happens when we are mompreneurs, you know, our kids are around trying to call the attention, you know, it happens. That's fine. So as Lisa was talking about, this topic, it's very, very important. Student loans, as all of you know, they're very, very expensive. It's not, you know, it's not cheap, you know, it's a huge, huge debt that people is on that, right, Lisa? It's a huge debt, the student loans. It's not like, it's not funny at all, you know?
Right, yeah, there's so much out there. It's just crazy. I don't remember the exact number, but it's in the trillions, I believe. Yeah, wow. I didn't say billions. I think it's in the trillions. So it's a huge number. So a couple of things. Thank you, Annie, for taking over. Basically what this, the Biden administration on a student loan relief program, right? Like he's talked about this forever, student relief, forgiveness, all these different things. So I just kind of wanted to run through this. One, I talked about the final extension for us not paying our student loans. If anyone's not paying the repayment, you'll have to start paying in January of 2023. And there's a simple process. I'm actually going to put this link in the chat as well for you guys so you can kind of read over it. Just so you have it in detail, because I don't want to go definitely into all the details, but there is loan forgiveness. You can apply for it. It looks like it's the target debt relief to low and middle income families. There's some income that you're going to have to go over. And of course, an application to fill out, right? Yes. Like one of the frequently asked questions is, how do I know if I'm eligible for a debt cancellation, right? To be eligible, your annual income must fall below $125,000 for individuals or $250,000 for married couples or heads of household. What does the up to $20,000 or up to $10,000 mean? There's two different categories. So it's forgiving $10,000, forgiving $20,000. The relief is a cap at the amount of your outstanding debt. For example, if you're eligible for a $20,000 in debt relief, but have a balance of $15,000 remaining, you will only be given the $15,000 in relief. So they're not going to give you any additional money, but they can forgive you for the amount that you have left. So I'm going to post this link. You guys can kind of read up on yourself. But if you do have student loans out there, if you have additional questions, please reach out to Annie or I. We can get you a consultation with one of our amazing student loan ladies. Her name is Brenda. She knows all the 411 on these things, and she can get you a really in-depth idea of what you're looking at come January. I wouldn't wait till last minute. I don't know if any of you have looked to see what your payment might be. It will tell you. Not anymore. It was going to, because we were supposed to start paying them this month. It will tell you in December, but let's look at it before December because we don't want to be blindsided come January. Not a good place to be, especially right after the holidays, right? So
yes.
With that, I'll go ahead and post this, Annie. You go ahead and transition into the life insurance side because we all know that it's life insurance awareness month. So go ahead and take that away while I post this here so people can have access to it.
Perfect. Thank you, Lisa. Yes, as you know, September is the Life Insurance Awareness Month. And why we celebrate this? Because it's so important that we can protect our family members, those people that we love. It's important to protect them because the reality is that we're not going to be around forever, you know, and we know that. So especially those people in their family that they are the ones who is, they're in charge of the finances, you know, sometimes still in this year, there is a lot of families that only one person is working. I don't mm-hmm. know how they do it, you know, because life is really expensive right now. And so just imagine if this person that is the one who worked died and it doesn't have life insurance, how this family is going to survive? That's the big question that I have all the time, you know? And that's why we see so many GoFundMe in social media. And yep. It breaks my heart when I see that because, you know, it's like a term insurance, just to tell something when you don't have like a lot of money, it's really, really affordable, you know? And with a term insurance, you can protect your loved ones. So, but going back to the topic of student loans, some people don't know that in the world of life insurance exists hybrid life insurance too. What is a hybrid life insurance? Is this type of life insurance that also has a saving account on the side. And I always recommend all those parents out there, if you have kids, since the moment that kid came to this world, start thinking about putting some money on the side and at some point start open one of these accounts. It's amazing. I did it as soon as I started my journey as a financial coach and I heard about these amazing accounts. I opened one for each of my kids. You know why? Because I thought for the future, you know, when my kids go to college, if they need some money to pay those student loans, there is going to be money there that is growing, you know, mm-hmm. and that's valuable. But most of people, well, some of those people that they really have that culture of saving, that we know that not everybody has it because our parents didn't teach, they never teach us to save, right? But those that they do, what they do, they go to the bank, right? They put the money there. It's making nothing. It's not really growing. And then when the students apply, you know, for help with the government and all these programs, they check. They see like what these people has in the bank, and they see this account. These accounts are there. But what happened if these kids have this life insurance with the saving account included? They are not gonna see it. because they're just life insurance, you know? So it's the perfect vehicle where you as a parent can put money to grow for your kid. And it's super affordable because, as most of you know, a life insurance, the price of that amount that you give monthly, it's based in your age and your health, right? So this is the great news. Imagine your kid being a baby, being just a 1 year old. How much are you gonna pay for the portion of life insurance of this kid? It's nothing, you know? It's nothing, mm-hmm. and you are just using it as a vehicle, you know, because some people can think like, why am I gonna buy a life insurance for my kid? It's just a kid. Okay, first of all, let me tell you this. Sadly, for dying, it doesn't exist an age. I know that it feels horrible to hear what I'm saying, but it's true, you know. You can die at any age. So that's number one. So you're just preventing if for some reason something happened, you have some money there. But the most important mm-hmm. reason why you can do this is to help the future of your kid. Let's say that your kid is super smart, right? It's super smart, the boy and the girl, and they get all these scholarships, full scholarships, and they don't have to pay any penny for loans for study in the university. Great. Now they have this money to buy a car, or they can use it to give a down payment for the house. You know, imagine the legacy that you are giving to your kids. And now when your kids are adults and they start working, they can continue paying this life insurance. You know, they take responsibility on this life insurance. You don't need to pay it anymore. You know, that's the legacy that you're giving to your kids. And now your kids continue paying it. And remember, the percentage that goes to the life insurance is so minimal because it's not going to change. It's not like, oh, because the kid now is an adult, that portion is going to get more expensive. No, it's the same. So it's just a vehicle that they're using to put money. And put money to grow. That's the great thing. Because the way that they work is these type of accounts mimic what the market is doing. So basing what the market is doing is how the portion that is in the saving account grows. So if the market do 7%, they do 7%, 8%, 10%, 12%, they do 12%. You know, imagine compare 12% to 1% that the bank gives you. Yeah, it's a huge difference, right, Lisa?
Yes.
So yeah, always think about this. Open your mind. You know, maybe you're listening and you're like, I already had life insurance. Let's check what type of life insurance you have also. You know, it's very, very important. I always say this to my clients. Each stage is different. We pass through different stages in life. What happens if you got, right? Like, let's say that you mm-hmm. get this type of accounts for your kid, but then your kid, it's not a kid anymore, get married, now has kids. Now that portion of life insurance, that is not enough for this person. Now they can get a different type of life insurance, an extra one, you know, because things happen, things change, the expenses change. And you have seen this year. It's unbelievable. You know how the prices went to the top, you know, like never before. So obviously, all the prices that you see right now in 2022, they're not going to be the same in 2030, you know, or 2040. It's going to be totally different. And you need to be prepared. And your kids need to be prepared. So I always recommend look for help, look for a financial professional. They can guide you. They can check where you are, what type of accounts do you have, and see if you already have a life insurance, see if that life insurance really fits your situation right now. I don't know if you heard before, but for example, millionaires and all these wealthy people, do you think that they only have one life insurance? Of course not. They have different ones, right? But what's the difference? That they sit down with financial advisors and they guide them. And when they have a lot of life insurance, do you think that they have term insurance? Maybe they have one there, but they take advantage, but they take advantage of this hybrid life insurance, you know, because it's a great vehicle to put your money to grow taxes free, you know, and it's like to have your own bank where if you need money in the future, you can take out money and then if you can put it back, you can put it back. You know, what happened with 401ks? We always talk about this, right? 401ks, there is so many people that they have emergencies because emergencies happen, right? And we know that there happens emergencies and then people go and touch their 401ks. And what happened with the 401k, there is a minimum age to be able to touch that money without paying penalties. And some people don't know about this. And then what's the surprise? The surprise is that when they take out the money, well, they have to pay taxes on that money. And besides that, they have to pay fees. What is the advantage of this life insurance hybrid that I was talking about? Here, there is no fee because it doesn't matter what age you are, it's your money, you know? So if you want to know more about this type of life insurance, you can go with Lisa or you can go with me and we can provide you more information. You know, remember this, years pass and like any other industry, like cars, you see cars, how different are now? The Teslas, imagine 30 years ago, 50, how cars were looking and now we have hybrid, we have full electrical. Well, the same happens with life insurance. The life insurance that we have now, they're not the same that we had 10 years ago, 20, 30 years, 40 years ago. And maybe some of you are gonna say, oh, Annie, but I got my life insurance so long ago and now I'm older, now it's gonna be more expensive. I don't think that that is a good time to get another one. Just let's give it a check. You don't lose anything. We don't charge for a check your documents and those accounts that you have. Just let's see if what you have it really fits you. If it really fits you, good for you, you know? But at least you know that a financial professional verified that everything is in order. And why I insist on this topic? Because it's very frequently that we hear out there that some people say, oh no, it's life insurance. I don't believe in life insurance because they don't pay. Have you heard that before? I have heard many times. And you know why they say that? Because maybe somebody happened, what happened to someone else is that they got a life insurance and they didn't know that the life insurance that they got was just for accidental death. And that happens a lot of times. Why? Because maybe the person that sold the life insurance, they knew that his client didn't have like a lot to put in this life insurance monthly. And the cheapest one was life insurance just for death, for accidental death. But the problem with this, if this individual has an accident and then from the accident that he has, he goes alive to the hospital and he die in the hospital, is determined that he died like a normal death. It's not an accidental death, it's a normal death. And that's when an accidental life insurance don't pay. So if you don't have clarity about what type of life insurance you have, please reach out to us. We're here to help. You know, we love what we do. We love our community. We just want that you be safe and also that your family members be safe and be protected. Because like I said before, I wish to live forever. Of course, I love my kids, right? I want to see my grandkids, great kids.
Yes.
But I don't know. Today, I am super healthy, everything is good, but we never know if tomorrow we're going to be here. So we really need to think about the future, about our kids, leave them protected. Also, think about us. If there is something that I learned from my community, my Hispanic community, is that sadly, I don't know why we have this tendency, okay? This is a tendency that we have that, especially in the past, maybe in this generation, not anymore, hopefully, but in the past, what used to happen is that we think like, oh, you know, my kids, I gave everything to my kids, so they owe me all that I gave for them, I sacrificed for my kids, so when I be old, they have to take care of me. That's the way that Hispanic community used to think. And it's wrong. Why? Why we have to put this heavy weight over the shoulders of our kids? That's not fair. I always think about that. And that's why the first thing that I did when I started my journey as a financial coach, I put my finances in order. Thinking about that, like in the future, when I be a senior, if my kids want to provide me something, it's because they want to do it, not because they have to do it. You know, I want to have my own accounts that can help me to, on my own, be able to take care of myself, you know, take care of my expenses and don't ruin the life of my kids. You know, so think about that for a moment, you know. It's very, very important that you think about that amazing love that you have for your family members, for your kids, for your parents, for everybody. Because like I said, there is no age for dying. And even if you're young, and let's say that you have parents and you have debts, because everybody has debts. You will use credit cards and or maybe you have a car loan or whatever. Think about that people, those family members, or that your husband, your wife, you know, the day that you die, that's another thing. I don't know if you know, but if you are married and you have debts, the day that you die, your debts are going to your significant other. So if you have a life insurance, at least after paying all your funeral and all the expenses with your death, the remaining money is going to go to your beneficiary. And with that remaining money, they can pay those debts or continue paying the mortgage. You know, like I said, if the husband is the only one who work and the wife is a housewife and the husband die, how this lady is going to continue paying the mortgage? They need a life insurance. And it's not just like, because sometimes I heard also out there people that say like, oh yeah, I don't need a life insurance, but because I already got a funeral package. They say, and I have everything ready. I have a funeral package. Yes, that's great. You have your funeral package, so you can pay for that.
But that only pays for the funeral. That doesn't pay for anything to continue on. Yeah.
Exactly. That's the thing. And so, yes, it's paid, but, and then, and what happened with the mortgage? What happened with the debts?
Right.
Yeah. Yes. So very, very important.
So true, Annie. Couple disclaimers. Annie's in California. I'm in Oklahoma. So just so you guys know, as far as debt carrying over to other spouse or different, it does actually depend on the state that you're in. I know a lot of states are not common law states. So depending on where you are, it might not pass to the spouse, but one, it's knowing about that, right? So if the debts of a spouse are still there, whether they carry on to the other one or not, will depend on where you live. But knowing that information is key. Number two, you know, what Annie said, we have to really start thinking about. One, death doesn't care what age we are at all. So it can happen at any time. And then the second thing, if you do have something in place, reach out, let's see if it still applies to your life today. Your life grows and changes and all these different things like Annie was talking about. So should your documents. so should the things that you do. You know, when we're so ready to go out, like we get a brand new phone and the first thing that we do is we put insurance on it, right?
Yes.
Just in case something happens to this brand new phone. Well, where's the life insurance for you and the family to protect them so that they don't have to change their lifestyle potentially if you pass on, right? Like you were talking about a spouse, that's a housewife, someone that's at home. If things aren't in place in the way that they should be, that entire life of the people that are left behind could be disrupted, uprooted, changed, let alone they're dealing with the passing of somebody very close to them. It's the fact that they also have to change other things. So, and then the crowdfunding, a lot of the GoFundMes, they can be great for some things. You guys, we're not like saying anything bad about GoFundMe accounts, but they don't protect the legacy of a family. They don't continue to carry on in a way so that the family can live differently or the same at that same level that they've been living, right? A lot of different reasons, and everything changes. Everything has evolved over years. And that's what we're trying to just get people to think about, right? We say a lot of the F words, the good F words, right? Family, fun, fitness, finance, like those are the good F words. We need to continue talking about those because they are so important to everything we revolve around every day. If you think about it, everything that revolves around us all day long somewhat fall into those categories, right?
Yes.
So who are we protecting? What are we protecting? And why are we protecting it? So I just to throw some thoughts out there, you know, and it doesn't hurt in any way to get something looked over. Have someone help you understand the policy you currently have. Just like she was talking about an accident policy. You know, if you have a term policy, but it's only going to cover you if you die in an accident, you have to die on the scene of the accident, not somewhere later. So it's the fine print. It's really, truly understanding what you have in place and how it protects you. And if it's even worth keeping. So just a great overall information, Annie. I think this is always great. I'm glad that we actually got some Zoom friends tonight. We have Mr. Reyes and we have Shauna. So we just wanted to say thank you guys for making it out here to listen to us. And anybody else on Facebook, you can always rewatch this. We'll keep the recording up. But Annie and I just want to leave you with that thought. It is Life Insurance Awareness Month. Really, truly sit down and think about how you want to protect them. I know you guys know, a lot of you know, especially on Facebook and social media, the story of my own family. We got hit with some really unexpected news in June. And so grateful and blessed that my sister's husband was covered with life insurance and that they're able to carry on and not have to have their life uprooted completely. Is there still changes that take place? Absolutely. There always will be when something like that happens, right? The bumps in the road, the shifts of life, the changes. But she's able to focus on what needs to be happening at the moment, which is just being there for her kids and herself. So I can't stress enough. It hit home to me. I've got my own. I've got things for my kids. And the other thing, when you get it, when you're healthy, like Annie was talking about, they're not denying you if you get sick. You are still covered.
That's so important.
That's hugely important, right? So while you're healthy, take care of things. So any final words? I mean, I could talk about this subject forever, but I think we just, you know, put some great thoughts out there, let people think about these things, and some last words, and we'll let everybody get on with their Friday evening.
Yes, there is another thought that came to my mind that I didn't mention, and it's very important because, again, I don't know, maybe there is another cultures that think like my culture, no, everybody, okay? But some people in my culture, some guys, they think, why am I going to get a life insurance to leave the money for the other guy that is going to enjoy my wife? They think, some guys think that way. So let me tell you something. This hybrid life insurance that I'm talking about, those accounts that they're attached, that money you can enjoy it in life, okay? So at some point in your life, when you're a senior, if you need to get out that money and use it for you because you need it, you can use it. Also, they have long-term care included that is so, so important. I don't know if you know, but it's super expensive if you want to pay from your pocket a nursing home, or if you need to pay a caregiver that is going to help you to take care of your loved ones. And sadly, everybody's going to be old at some point, and we don't know how good we're going to be when we be seniors. We don't know if we're going to be capable to, you know, to do things on our right. own. And what happened?
I'm going to be climbing mountains.
Professional help, right? I hope. I see myself in my 80s still in the gym. Right. That's how I see it. But what happened if that's not the case? And I need exactly. someone that give me a shot, give me a bath, and, you know, help me to change and everything. I need to have money for that. And these hybrid accounts, they have included long-term care. So it's super important. So don't think that just all the money is going to the beneficiaries. It's up to you. You can leave everything for the beneficiary, or you can use some money when you're alive. Okay. So think about yes. that. Very important. The senior years, we should enjoy it the most we can. And like I always say this, money, I know that money is not the most important thing, but it's so helpful, because without money, when you are a senior, you're not gonna be capable to survive and have your golden years in the way that you deserve. So please think about that. And like I said, if you need more knowledge, if you need some guidance with the topic of life insurance, you can go with Lisa, you can go with me. We'll be happy assisting you. We're not gonna charge you for our consultation is free, and we can give you some lights. And like Lisa said, if we pay insurance for our cell phone, that is so important for us, and I agree, my cell phone is very important. It's my mini computer. And mm-hmm. yes, I pay insurance for him. How much valuable is your life? That's the right. question that I wanna leave in your head. If your cell phone is so valuable that you're paying insurance for it, how valuable is your life and the life of your loved ones? Think exactly. about that and reach out if you need more guidance. Lisa, do you want to add something?
No, I mean, that's a tough question for all of them to answer and ponder. So we're going to let you guys ponder that. We'll keep you posted for our next upcoming events. Please just watch our social media. And again, we thank you guys for tuning in. We really appreciate you being here. We appreciate you following us and supporting us. And we wish you all the best. Enjoy the rest of your Friday. Be safe. Enjoy. And always
thank
make
you,
sure
Lisa. You have smile. Thank you, Annie. Thank you guys so
You're
much.
Very, very welcome. Thank you
thank
guys
you,
so
Reyes.
Much.
Thank you, Shanna. Thank you, everyone. Have a great weekend.
Bye.
Bye.